When you update your Final Cut Pro to a new version, as you will have just done with 10.7, if you're like me, you'll want to wait before upgrading all the previous 10.6 libraries to work with that new 10.7 version. But there may be times when you'll want to open libraries that have been upgraded to 10.7 and open them with 10.6, perhaps because of issues with plugins that don't work with the new Final Cut Pro. In the worst case scenario, you may have decided to permanently revert back to the previous Final Cut Pro. I'll show you the secret to the quick switching of Final Cut Pro versions 10.7, 10.6, back and forth as you wish. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe and press the bell so that I can make more videos like this for you. As most of you are aware, it's good practice to compress into a zip file the older Final Cut Pro application before updating it to the new version. And if you want to know how to do that, click on the link above for a video that'll show you. Once zipped, it's easy to expand the 10.6 zip file, but only after you've put the currently working version of 10.7 in the trash. And if you need to frequently switch from 10.7 to 10.6 and back, there's no reason to have to expand the zip file every time you want to do it. Just drag the trash version back into the applications folder. But only do that after you've tracked the version that's current in the applications folder at that time. And this is how to do it. Let's have a look in the applications folder. The 10.6.10 version of Final Cut Pro is there. And there's also zip versions of 10.7, 10.6.10, and 10.6.6. Those are backups, should they ever be needed in the future. And you'll also see in the trash folder a previously tracked version of 10.7. I'm going to remove the currently active 10.6 version and trash it by right-clicking on it. And at this point, you may be asked to confirm with a password. You'll see now that 10.6.10 is also in the trash folder. So the next step is to move the 10.7 version from the trash into the applications folder so it becomes the currently active version of Final Cut Pro. And this time you will be asked for a password. And now you'll see 10.7 in the applications folder. Double click to launch that 10.7. And since this is 10.7 now running, you'll be asked if you want to upgrade to any recently opened 10.6 libraries. Since I don't want to update this particular library, I'll cancel here. But I can select a 10.7 library from the Open Library menu. Now let's switch back again to the 10.6.10 version. Currently, if I try to trash the 10.7 version by right-clicking and selecting Move to Trash, obviously it won't do it because Final Cut Pro needs to quit. So, quit Final Cut Pro, right-click again and Move to Trash. Insert the password if it asks for it. And you'll see that 10.7 has moved from the Applications folder again and it's now in the trash. To be able to switch back to 10.6.10 again, move it from the trash to the Applications folder. And you'll see it appear in the Applications folder and launch it by double-clicking the 10.6.10 from there. And what you've seen is a really quick way to switch from one version of Final Cut Pro to another. And one other thing, if you accidentally update a 10.6 library to 10.7, there's a way to convert that back to 10.6. Click at the link above for a video about that. And if you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and press the bell and you'll be notified when I publish the next video about the 10.7 upgrade. Thanks for watching.